Hear much of a difference? Well, that's probably a good thing, and that's what makes this MIRA optical compressor from Walrus Audio such a great product. It's got about 8 different algorithms with which you can squeeze your tone, but it doesn't actually squeeze the tone too much. All compressors will inject a little tiny bit of coloring because that's just the nature of them, but an optical compressor generally doesn't inject much, and it feels good. It feels really smooth. And the MIRA is as much about the experience for the player as it is about the tone and the way that it glues the tones together in a mix. So having said that, this is a Charvel ProMod HSS with a Seymour Duncan JB in the back and SSL 6s, also by Seymour. It's running directly into an XFX Fender 6G4 Super Combo model, which is a very clean old brownface amp and a perfect platform with which to demonstrate the MIRA optical compressor from Walrus Audio. So first of all, let's back this off to Unity kind of settings so I can switch it on and off and compare. And then I can go through all of these different settings and show you what they do. I hope that I can do it well, because it's a big job, because there's a lot going on here. All right, that's pretty much at Unity between having it on. And having it off. Not a lot of difference. So up the top here, on the top left, we've got threshold. And threshold, when I wind it counterclockwise, will determine at what point the guitar is going to kick in the compressor. At the moment, it's wound all the way clockwise, so there's no threshold. If I wind it up to here, you can see the LED kicking in as gain reduction. But you can't hear much going on. Because in the other corner, the blend control is wound to completely dry signal, so no compression signal at all. If I wind it up to noon, it's getting loud. Back the level off, Brett. But there's no compression going on. That's because I haven't got any ratio dialed in. Ratio is from 1 to 1, which is no compression, all the way clockwise to about 20 to 1, which is almost limiting. I'm going to put it somewhere in the middle, which I guess will be about, you know, somewhere between 6 and 10 to 1. I'm going to wind blend all the way up. Oh, we can't hear it anymore. Well, because of that, we've got a make-up gain up here to make up the signal. And a level control down in the bottom left. All right, now it's getting squeezy. Feels just great. great under the fingers. But what if I want a little bit of dry signal? If I put dry signal back in, it's going to retain the transients of the attack. And it's going to inject the parallel compressed signal. Parallel compression is what they call it in the studio. So you've got a bit of both. You've got the dry signal and you've got the compressed signal following it through with some more sustain. If it's not enough sustain, we've got a little release trim pot down here, which we can turn up to get it to hang on to the note. You see the gain reduction LED? Slowly fading out. If I turn the release down, it should fade out a bit quicker. And it does. I'm going to bump that release up so we've got maximum sustain. Next to it on its left is the attack, and that determines the attack or the speed of the attack of the compressor coming in. So it can go nice gentle slope if I turn it up slow, or it can just ram it in home if I've turned it down. So that's slow attack, here's fast attack. Turn the blend knob up, you'll hear that a bit more. Fast attack. Slow attack. I'm going to bring that dry signal back in a little bit more and bump the threshold down a bit. Now, both of those signals sound great, I think, but very little difference. A slight bit of smooth coloration coming from Myra. But it's about the experience of playing. It feels good because it's kind of making it squeezy and compressed under the fingers. It's a very positive thing. Now, that'll work equally as well for the humbucker. But you probably won't need as much makeup gain and you probably won't need as much threshold. On the side of the Myra, you'll find a high-pass filter switch which will basically turn off compression below 120 Hz. So if you're a bass player and you don't want that bottom end to be squeezed as much as the top end, that's a little knob you want to push in. Not going to make much difference on this super strat kind of guitar, but it's there, which is a very considerate offering, I think, from Walrus Audio. Earlier today, I took this guy for a run with a backing track from JTC Guitar, that's Jam Track Central, and used the Myra in the way that I would use it live or in the studio. Here it is. We'll be right back. thank you for watching. If you're looking for a high-grade optical compressor, the guys at Walrus Audio have come up with the MIRA. It's a ripper. See you soon.